welcome back to my channel. I'm Ria, wedding designer and stylist from Confetti Sweethearts, and I love helping couples like you have fun while you plan your day. So in today's video, I'm going to be chatting all about the sweetheart table because it has become increasingly popular over the last year, with couples choosing it for the layout of their design in their room. So we're chatting all about what it is and why you would maybe want to choose it. Basically, a sweetheart table is just for the two of you, so just for the couple. There is no other family and friends or wedding party on the table with you. It's just a table for two people. This takes off some of the pressure of having to choose who sits on the top table with you. So with extended families and the wedding party and close friends, couples are finding it increasingly difficult to seat all the VIPs. So, you know, how do you treat all your family and friends the same when you've got to like choose who you want to join you on that special table? Definitely takes some of the stress away and some of the pressure, and you're just keeping it simple. You're just having the two of you on your special table, and then the rest of your guests, you can put wherever you like so that everybody's happy. It really does depend on your situation, like your family unit and your wedding party. It all depends on the dynamic of things as to what kind of thing you want to do when it comes to having a sweetheart table or not. There's also another reason why you might want to choose a sweetheart table. It might purely be from an aesthetic point of view. Like, it's becoming very popular with couples to choose this because it actually creates a really nice focal point in the venue itself. So it might suit a sweetheart table. It might be able to carry it off really well, depending on what your layout is. It might just actually fit in better. I know that a lot of teepee venues suit this kind of sweetheart table style because of the position of the poles. So you might be having really long banquet style tables, and it might suit you to have a sweetheart table at the end of all your other guests. So you see, it might just be from a style point of view that you want to create that kind of look in your venue, rather than it being doing away with a top table and having all the VIPs on it with you. It's just thinking about it in a different way, like what's gonna work in your space. So it's important to highlight what the actual pros are when it comes to choosing a sweetheart table. And one of them is that it can create some time just to yourselves, because obviously the wedding day is very hectic. You might have a lot of people around you, and you know, it's really tough to get those moments of just you as a couple, like, so enjoying each other's company, like, and it will slow the day down a little bit. So while you're having your meal, obviously you can have that time together while you're eating, and you've got time to chat without any distractions. Also means that you'll be able to eat properly, because when you have lots of other guests with you, you're more inclined to be chatting to them. It ensures that you sit down and you eat your dinner together, which will be really essential for enjoying the rest of the evening. It also makes a fantastic focal point in the venue, depending on the layout, obviously. So you can really go to town with the decoration of a sweetheart table to help frame you. It will look fantastic in photographs. So basically, we're seeing lots of fun decor pieces. You could have like an over the head decor piece over the top of the table with hanging lights and foliage. You could have like a backdrop so that it frames the both of you. And we are even seeing lots of floor arrangements. So if you have the space at the bottom and you've got space between like you and the other tables, then you could have like a floor arrangement in front of the table so that it helps frame it. So you see, there's lots of things that you can do there. Also have some statement chairs, like peacock chairs are very popular in teepees, which help you stand out and make you feel like a little bit more special to your guests. Another pro with having a sweetheart table is that actually your other guests might feel less intimidated coming up to the both of you than if they were coming up to a whole table full of your family and friends. So between courses, they might decide to come up and chat to you more freely than if your whole family were sat there. So there's obviously that to consider as well, that it actually can work work as a more sociable space. One of the cons of having a sweetheart table is that you could feel like you're a little bit distant from your other guests. So you could feel like you're a little bit left out of the conversation and you're a little bit distant from everybody. But the key to avoiding this feeling is to make sure that your sweetheart table isn't too far away from everybody else. It just wants to be far enough away so that you've got that intimacy, but also so that you feel part of it. And obviously there's no reason why you can't get up yourself in between courses and go and visit your guests and then come back to your seat. So you've still got that time together, plus you're interacting with your guests as well. It really does depend on the position of your table and what kind of guests you've got, what you think they would do and what you would do. Obviously, it's making sure that it works in your venue. So working with the space to ensure that this idea would actually work in there, like visually and practically as well, because there's nothing worse than it feeling awkward. So it has to work in the space really well. So obviously your coordinator or your stylist will help you decide whether this is a really good idea. Like I say, it is becoming more and more popular in venues. I think it is a great idea if you want something a little bit different and you're finding it difficult, especially to decide who joins you on the top table. And I just think as we move forward with weddings, that I think that this is more of a modern approach now. And, you know, it really does feel like a little bit more up to date. So definitely consider it if you're thinking about your layout and where you want to put all of your guests. I just think it is a great idea. So I hope you have enjoyed this video and found it useful. So please let me know in the comments below if you are considering having a sweetheart table for your wedding. If you have enjoyed today's video, please remember to give it a thumbs up. And if you want to receive notifications of when a new video goes live, please remember to hit subscribe. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you in my next video.